travel back in time to experience the Middle Ages at the Louisiana Renaissance Festival. Explore the English village of Albright at the height of the 16th century and enjoy jousting tournaments, dueling, juggling, magic, and falconry. Meet the Queen. Experience the charms of musical minstrels. See real blacksmiths, glass blowers, candle makers, and so much more. And shop for fantastic and unique items you can't find anywhere else. The Louisiana Renaissance Festival.
We're back in downtown Hammond on Thomas Street in the building that used to be Sweet Rolls, where it's soon going to be a Raymond restaurant. That's not what we're really talking about today, but it's just sort of an intro for Trenten Oliphant, who is from the Depeaux in Independence. This will not be your new location. It will just be another restaurant.
Yeah, it's going to be a totally new concept. We're going to ramen house, Cajun-Asian fusion. Just a cool place. We're going to do late night stuff. And it's coming soon, hopefully by the start of next year.
One of the good things about acquiring this building is that it used to be a restaurant.
Yeah. It's definitely a lot simpler to put together than the Depeaux was. You know, the Depeaux had popcorn ceiling and carpet floors. And so we had to do a lot more work in there. But this should be not easy, but easier than that.
What a departure from the Depeaux.
Yeah. So we're, I'm a classically trained chef. And so, I don't just cook chicken wings or cheeseburgers. So we got this, and then we have another concept in the work for Hammond over by the college. But this is coming first.
So what will be on the menu more or less? Obviously, noodles.
Well, yeah. So we're going to do your classic, authentic Japanese style ramen. And then we're also going to have stir-fry dishes, classic Chinese stir-fry, and takeout style food. And then we're also going to have some Cajun-Asian fusion, things like hoghead cheese fried rice, praline sticky ribs, blue crab rangoons, different stuff like that.
So what's the difference between an authentic bowl of ramen and what we're used to eating, like maybe in the packets from the supermarket?
Well, it probably all starts, instead of just pouring water in with the noodles and microwaving it for 2 minutes, the broth alone for real ramen takes at least 12 hours. And then you have other things like the chasu pork, which is, takes hours to make. You develop so many flavors in each step of the way, and it just comes together for what is one of my favorite foods.
Is it basically made from rice? The authentic noodles.
No. So it's a wheat noodle ramen. It's made with really high alkaline water, and it's real bouncy. So it's not like your Italian style noodles where it's kind of al dente. It is al dente, but it's got more bounce to it.
Well, that's interesting. What is your opening date, you think?
We're hoping for January, but no promises yet.
And you'll be open late hours.
Yeah, so we're looking Friday and Saturday open till 3 a.m. We're not probably not going to open until January, but we are doing pop-ups at some local breweries. So just be on the lookout for that. We're about to launch our Facebook page for it. So we'll be doing different things where you can taste the food before we're actually open.
How's the Depeaux doing?
The Depeaux's doing good. It's still rolling along. We're moving in. I'm starting to kind of move away and venture out. And then we got new people coming in that are going to start running that. But it's still going to be exciting, fresh, Louisiana ingredients. I always like to say it's a Buffalo Wild Wings that tries a little harder.
Well, plus, you have great burgers.
Yeah. We probably sell 50% burgers, and then the rest of it shares the other 50%. But people love our burgers.
And you're imaginative about your burgers.
Yeah, so right now it's burger month. Well, it's coming to an end now, but we did a new burger every week. We do that. 100% Hereford beef patties, no fillers, nothing like that. It's just straight beef. We make our own pickles. We make all of our sauces, and we use nice soft potato buns.
Now you have, in addition to being a gourmet chef, you're also a graduate of the Pro Start program at Hammond High School.
Yes, I am. Culinary competitive team there, and some other things, just helped out with all their catering and stuff. And then I was there for 2 years, and that really set me up for culinary school.
So let's just continue completely off the subject. We have yet to address the real point of the interview, but thinking about that Pro Start, voters in the Hammond School District are going to consider whether or not to renew the magnet program. And it just occurs to me, having these great programs at Hammond High, yes, maybe some people from other communities avail themselves of going to Hammond High, but isn't it great? Isn't it wonderful to have, for example, the ProStart program?
Yeah, well, and I mean, not to mention the Hammond Pro Star program is one of the top in the states, you know, consistently places every year in the competition, and they go off to nationals, and they have one of the nicest kitchens. You know, if you compare Hammond's Pro Star kitchen to Albany's Pro Star kitchen, it's nothing, you know. It's nowhere in comparison. You know, they have a facility that they spent a lot of money building, so it sucked to see that go to waste. And I mean, the reality is I would have never went to Hammond High if it wasn't for the magnet program, because I lived in LaRonger, so I would have went to LaRonger. And then if I never went to Hammond, then none of this would have even happened.
That's a good point. Well, now the point of the interview, which is that there's a great contest coming up. S&W Wholesale is behind it, and it's to benefit one of the greatest charities I think we've ever established in our area, our Daily Bread.
Yeah, for sure, for sure. We're helping raise money for that. All you have to do is go into the restaurants that are participating. They'll have table tents or posters. You can scan the QR code, and then you donate. And in the middle of donating, it'll ask you your favorite restaurant. You click on the restaurant you want to support. And none of the money goes to the restaurants. It's all 100% to our Daily Bread. But it's just you select that restaurant, and then the top three raising restaurants go to a cook-off, and then they get a wrestling belt, and I think that belt would look real nice on one of my shelves in my house.
So it starts out with the customers at the restaurants voting when they go there to have dinner.
Yeah. So it's really any type of donation. You know, they don't have to be sitting at your restaurant to do it. They're sitting at their home. They can go to feedingtangie.com and donate there. And yeah, like I said, you don't have to be at the restaurant and scan the QR code. You can still choose the restaurant you want to support from your home and donate from your home all on your phone.
Well, and I can't think of a better charity. Did I read correctly that they do 14,000 meals a day?
Yeah.
Did I miss a decimal place?
Yeah, it's something like that. I know, I think 150,000 meals this year that y'all are on track for. 1,400 twice a week, yeah. So yeah, they're on. They're already breaking their meals that they did last year in September. So you know they're rolling on hard, and they need the support of the parish more than ever.
You know, I think about myself, and boy, I need to lose weight. And I think about that when I decide what to have for lunch. And we have so many great restaurants in this area. Most of us take for granted that we don't have to go hungry.
Yeah.
But it's a poverty of riches in our area. There are so many who do go hungry.
Yeah, there's a lot of underprivileged people in our area, and it's some that we don't even realize. You know, just because somebody isn't homeless doesn't mean that they're not struggling. You know, we do the Tangie prayer meeting at the depot, and right now we're in the middle of raising money to buy every kid that goes to Head Start in the parish Christmas gifts. So it's like 550 kids, I think, but they're all there because they're underprivileged, and you know, maybe their parents have to work, and so they don't have, you know, they have to work to raise money for their family, and so they put them in Head Start, and Head Start is a good program too that helps underprivileged families and everything.
So again, all we have to do if we're going to participate is support our local restaurant and either go to the website or go to the restaurant.
Yeah, if you go to the restaurant, you can scan it on your phone, or if you're at home or don't know how to use a QR code, just www.feedingtangie.com. And it'll pop up with the donate button. And like I said, you can click on your favorite restaurant, which should be the Depeaux. And then you can donate under there. And you can hopefully send your restaurant to the final cook-off.
What else do you want to share with us?
Nothing else really at this moment. But just be on the lookout for Bento opening up, hopefully early next year. And check out the Depeaux if you're ever in Independence. Well, a lot of people, Independence really isn't that far. If you're in downtown Hammond, it'll take you 15 minutes. So take the drive, come eat some wings and cold beer and fresh hamburgers.
It takes more than one person to assist in a personal injury claim. I am attorney Glenn Westmoreland, and we have a strong team at the Mack Law Firm. It is our goal to make sure your injury is properly attended to. Contact me at tangielawteam.com and let us get you the help you need.